That's a wrap from round one of the Tour Championship by Coca-Cola, the culmination of the 2013-2014 season. We are well underway to having one player lift at FedEx Cups come Sunday. But first, let's take a look at what happened in round one. We'll pick it off on the first hole, and it's Justin Rose on the first. This for birdie from about 15 feet out to get off his round to a good start as he drains that one. And then we'll head over to Ryan Palmer, one of the hottest players with the flat stick right now late in the season, finding his touch at just the right time as he drains that 38-footer. That was one of the longest putts we saw all day long. Russell Henley, a winner earlier this season, trying to see if he can cap it off with a victory in Atlanta, the University of Georgia Bulldog. His second shot as he sticks it to 7 feet from 139 yards out. He would go on to convert that one for birdie on his first hole of the day. Then over to Patrick Reed, a new father, a winner. A lot going on for Reed. First Ryder Cup team, too, in just a couple weeks as he drains that 8-footer. Bill Hosnow, a former FedEx Cup champion, knows how to get it done on this East Lake golf course from 136 yards out. Stuffs it to 4 feet, 5 inches. Also is able to convert that birdie. Over now to Jason Day. Had quite the day. His caddy had a pullout on the front nine with a pinched nerve in his back. So even with a substitute caddy, Day draining a 29-footer here on the first, he would finish off at 3 under par. That is just one off the lead. Rory McIlroy sitting at even par as he begins his round. This is his third shot after finding himself in the trees with his second shot. Nearly holds out for the birdie with save par, though. A great par save for Rory to start off his day. Chris Kirk now, a winner last week, which puts him atop the FedEx Cup standings for the first time in his career. This from 127 yards out to 6 feet on the first. Guys, not finding a lot of birdies on the course, but they were finding a lot on that opening hole. Sergio Garcia now on the sixth from 11 feet out. He has been playing some tremendous golf. 3 runner-up finishes this season. That kind of great golf, he actually feels kind of mentally tired. It takes a lot out of you to play solid golf. Another man that has found himself playing some great golf all year, especially at the major championships, Ricky Fowler, as he makes a 37-footer there for birdie. He needed 30 putts, though, if he can clean up that putting. Fowler said he can do much better than 1 under par he did on Thursday. Hunter Mahan there on the sixth. He began his day 2 over par, but worked his way back into red numbers. Then back to Rory McIlroy on the 16th, sitting at even par at this point. And McIlroy staring this one down. He likes it, and he should, as he leaves himself 7 feet here for birdie. McIlroy, world number one, finishing at 1 under par. He is 3 back, heading into round two. Over to Kevin Na, sitting at 1 over at this point. This on 18 for a long birdie to finish at even par. And he gets it to go. That would be great momentum for Na heading into Friday after battling it all day long. Zach Johnson on 18-tee here at 1 under, trying to get one last birdie as well. 18 playing 224 yards. And Zach Johnson hitting it almost right on the numbers. He would leave himself 4 feet there for the birdie, which he would go on to convert. We will leave you here with Ricky Fowler. I heard this cheer from 2 holes over. You will shortly see why. He nearly holds it as he finishes his day at 1 under par. As I said, I talked to Ricky after his round, and he said, I took 30 putts. If I can clean it up on the short grass, I think I'll be good to go heading in to the last 3 rounds of the Tour Championship by Coca-Cola. Remember, we have early tee time starting on Friday. 8:45 is the first tee time, and PGAtour.com's live at coverage will have you covered right at 8:45 a.m. all the way until the final putt drops on Friday.